normally when you lose the last game of the season, whether it's Worlds or whether it's, you know, playoffs or whatever it is, you think back at the year and you're like, where did all this go wrong? Like, where was the moment I fucked up or whatever, to go from the 17-1 split with 9-1 record in playoffs into 9-0 summer split start? How do we go from that to losing to Golden Guardians, Warner Thieves, EG, etc., to losing to FlyQuest, a team that we are 7-0 against this year? Like, what happened in this time frame, right? That's what I want to figure out. And yeah, here we are. The first half started and ended exactly how I thought it would. We went 9-0 in a very dominant fashion.
There is nothing else for TSM to do. Cloud9 undefeated in the first round, Robin.
Personally, I don't remember 9 of the games at all.
Yeah, I mean, a part of it is because like those 9 games, it's just because we were actually playing the same way that we were in spring. We didn't really change much, it just was working.
We were kind of riding off our momentum from last split. We had that kind of momentum going for us, so we were able to kind of roll through the first half of the season.
We were looking really good, and I felt super confident in the team.
First, I thought that the level of play was getting better, but looking at week 4 especially, I thought the level was incredibly low. Teams like Team Liquid look terrible.
I'm still surprised that TSM and TL are looking really bad. We need competition here and there right now. If it goes the same way as it did last split, then it's gonna be harder for us to perform at Worlds, in my opinion. Even though I think we can still do it, it's just gonna be way easier if someone challenges us here in NA first, so that we can improve already.
So I think right on our game with 100 Thieves, which is I think game 10 of the split, was our first loss. And you know, it wasn't a fluke.
Unconscious is gonna run at him.
Doesn't have to stop.
Bunker
is broken. Yeah, that's just a kill. Sven can't do anything. Galio finds two with the knock up though. Ulti's in. Make it two on the Blabber. That could be Baron straight away.
Cloud9 on the precipice of their first loss here.
Even before we started losing, I think we all knew that we weren't as strong as we were this split before.
We started trying some more stuff. Senna, Wukong, so on Lux comes to mind here. And we lost to Warner Thieves with the Sun of Wukong after being TSM with it.
Sunday's charging in, 100 Thieves gonna end the game right here as they're gonna get absolutely everybody. Yeah, Cody, he's gonna die again, but Contracts lives and the Thieves are gonna charge down mid to hand Cloud9 their first loss of the summer.
I kind of just brushed it off as experimenting, and against EG, our draft was also really bad.
Cloud9, they went 17-1 in the spring split. They lost only one game in playoffs. I don't see a reason why C9 cannot just keep that same record over here in summer and get a nice 8-0 run to end out the split. See if they can do it here as we are on to the Rift for our second game of the day, Evil Geniuses versus Cloud9.
It looks like Golden Glue might be starting for EG.
No way.
You okay there?
Yeah, I just said no. I don't think there's any way, but maybe.
I think that there is. There's an ESPN article that just came out.
I think
it's likely
Pog.
That Golden okay. Glue is starting for EG and they'll play Huni in the top lane.
I mean, if I face Golden Glue, I think it's gonna be easier for us.
Can Licorice do it all? The arrow's going to land onto the son of the mid laner. The fight comes through and it's going to be Golden Glue securing it, plus the kill. Mountain Soul through for Evil Geniuses. The gold is nearly tied. EG are beating Cloud9.
Okay, fuck. We're not in a good spot right now.
Two games in a row, Cloud9 will be upset. And this is an exciting split here in summer. Who is the best team in the league? Clearly C9 are mortal.
Well, it's two losses in a row now. Yeah. You know, memes aside, they haven't been looking as dominant. This was not any weird draft. This was pretty standard C9 stuff. They just got outplayed at the end of the day.
It's a sad game to play.
We saw that in our scrims that we were struggling, and it wasn't that we were necessarily getting worse, but there were some meta shifts that were happening, and the competition for summer 2020 was really heating up.
Mm-hmm.
mean, when a team as good as we were goes on a losing streak like that, there's always going to be a lot of reasons for like why it's going wrong. And always the easiest one to talk about, like the most obvious, is always going to be the draft. But even like draft aside, like there were lots of games that we lost that we had no business losing, like the game versus Team Liquid.
Yeah, like I think us being tied with TL is like uber cringe, because like I said before, I don't think they're as good as their score is. And whenever we scrimmed Team Liquid, we turbo them like 5-0. And it's like not even funny, you know?
TL in general is honestly not that bad, but I don't think they're nearly as good as their record, and I don't think they're nearly as good as us.
Tries to find a kill into Niski, but here comes the reinforcements just in time for the shields, the ult, and the kill. Niski walks away like nothing ever happened. Two kills plus a turret, Cloud9 even farther ahead.
Like, we were up 5-6k gold with like a scaling comp, like Shen ult in the side lane. Like, there's no reasonable way that like any team should ever lose that game, and like, we lost it.
Mid-game focus composition from Cloud9, but I think they have a lot more mid-game to work with. What a pull! Big punk there. Goodbye to Sven. Re-engage for tactical blabber. You don't want this one. Ult's back in. Tries to get what he can. It's not going to be the ulti for Lux landing either, and that's a 2-0.
I hate losing, and I hate it even more when I am one of the main reasons we lost.
It is a 4v3 for Team Liquid, and they go in for the pillar. They're going to find that kill on the Vulcan, but he flashes away for dear life. Still not going to be enough. Tactical flashes in for the chase, and suddenly it is 4v2, and the base will be cracked, and Team Liquid will look to take down Cloud9.
I was just disappointed in myself, mostly, and it sucks to lose a game like that and tie for first place when I think we're better, so.
We lost in a pretty embarrassing way with the lead that we had. I think it should have been a clean win from us, but we just fucked up.
So you can't blame games like that on draft, but I think that having good drafts would go a really long way to making us play a lot better and like feel more comfortable on stage.
Draft itself is a team skill. It's not like, yeah, our players are fucking great and we lost from the draft, blah, blah, blah. It's not. We are all the players and coaches and all the champions, patches, we are on the, all of the things are on the table and we are talking about it, and we have a draft meeting and we prepare. If it doesn't work, which means our, yeah, we are shit, you know? It's that simple.
I think drafting is always both a coach and a player thing. Us not knowing what to do versus Golden Guardians when they pick 1-2 Kalista is my fault, not Reaper's fault. We should be more prepared for that happening. We said they only played one game of Kalista this split, they probably won't pick it, then they pick it and we weren't prepared for it, which is just almost lazy, I would say. And yeah, it's not good enough from a team like us.
Grab that first kill. Liquor is still going to be kept alive for now as Niski goes for the damage onto FBI, but the spears are flying and Licorice is dying. It's Sven finding some auto attacks onto Huhi. Cloud9 still looking to make more damage happen with their carries here. Sven could be in some danger. Closer's looking to take him down, and they will find him critically. It's FBI taking down the Cloud9 marksman. Haunter continues the push, continues the chase, continues the battle, and continues to live a huge victory in this team fight for the Golden Guardians.
Like, even just like outside of lane phase in late game, like Kalista was just like walking up 1v5 and we had like nothing to do to him. Like, we had no tools to deal with it.
And the Golden Guardians will upset Cloud9. They will put the last little bit of damage into the Nexus and they will take that win.
Golden Guardians will bring it home. Another loss delivered to Cloud9.
I think we're just bad right now. I think we need to drop the ego and just improve. We just have work to do, I think.
It's tough because I feel like the issue changes a bit game to game. Previous to today's game, I thought that our biggest issue was that we were drafting too much to our opponents and not enough to like what we want to play. And like we wanted to take away their comfort picks and like pick them away or ban them away, as opposed to like making sure we get a comp that we like. And we talked about that a lot yesterday, and then like today we had different problems. So like we're just struggling to get like a team comp that we like in the pick ban phase, and then the games just feel really, really hard, even if we are doing well individually.
There's the start of the front line. They're going now. Devil Force a flash away and rooted up means nothing else. In the back line goes Broken Blade, wants those kills, gets one. Looks for number two. Niski's very, very low. Licorice on the way out. And they're going to pick up a couple of kills still. Flash away, but still rooted in place. TSM wiping the floor with Cloud9.
This is the attempt. Can it happen for Cloud9? Damage comes through and Dublin has been killed. But can they do the rest? Broken Blade flashes in, looks for kill number one, grabs that one, looks at the re-engage, the top leader's dead. Sven is next. Broken Blade cleans in the back line. Cloud9 will fall. TSM will be the one to do it, and they will take that next.
Yeah, we were pretty shit right there. We were pretty shit that week. Yeah, this is like, with the drafts that happened, we pretty much went into the game with like a 20%, 30% chance of winning.
For a losing team, I think the team atmosphere was actually like quite good. I think that me and my teammates are always really focused on just trying to make sure that we win as much as possible and that we're all really competitive people. So honestly, like, the atmosphere was like decent, and a lot of the times when you're going on losing streaks like that, especially with teams where you're like supposed to be winning and there's a lot of pressure on you, it can get really bad, and it wasn't like that at all.
Yes, it's too much. I don't like the shrimp.
Oh, there's no shrimp in yours.
Oh, there's no shrimp? Also, there's no, I don't want cucumbers.
You want cucumbers? Why does your sheet say cucumbers? Oh no.
But like, this is so cringe.
Oh, no. It's okay.
I mean, it's the same, it's fine.
That was my first O2 week ever. For me, I was like really upset about it. Obviously, we lost, right? But as a team, we were still very lighthearted towards each other, and we're still making jokes. It's never been a struggle for us because I do think we're really close.
What do you want, Cali, from me? I'm not Broken Blade. I'm not a content machine. I need to oink alone, not in front of a camera.
Yo, Vulcan's right here.
No, please, he's watching.
Look at him. Look, he's watching something. He's watching something, Calvin.
Avatar. Thought it was bad at first, but it's getting better now.
You thought Avatar was bad at first?
Yeah, the first few episodes were kind of boring.
Yeah, they're actually kind of boring. But you're
We got to do O2 week. Morale was fine after those losses. I mean, no one likes losing, right? We want to win every game, but we all know how good we were before, and we are all very confident that we can go back to that level if we're not at that level right now. So,
Cloud9 has started slipping.
Cloud9 did more than start slipping. They fell on their ass already. Feet are in
the
air.
They're rolling backwards. They're flailing everywhere.
It's nice that our opponents aren't going to be like super tough in the last week, because like right now we're struggling a lot, and like if we, even if we lose to them, which I don't think is the end of the world, like if we lose to them, then we'll like be like, okay, like actually we just have to start from scratch and figure it out, because like playoffs is coming and we got to do it. And if we like take wins and we like maybe struggle a little bit, we can like figure out more like where we need to put our attention and our effort in order to get better for playoffs.
One, two, three, sit
down! The game felt like shit, honestly. Didn't feel like we did anything proactive, didn't feel like we did anything really well. Honestly, I felt like we were slowly losing the game, but since we were scaling better than them, we were able to just stall, I guess. And then also they made like a huge mistake at the end.
Shockwave is up in 4, 3, 2, no, the Baron's already taken. Can he push it forward for a kill? He's not gonna use it just for Phoenix. And unfortunately, Dignitas spreads, yes, he will. They're kind of reconsidering the play here. Phoenix with another shield coming out. They're going to try to run. He says, don't bring him to me. Johnson's got to run now. Licorice teleports in. It's never ending, Kobe. Phoenix trying to do what he can versus 3, and he seems unkillable, but that's just not true.
The game itself didn't feel too great, but I mean, it feels good to win, I guess.
I'd say winning is important for us right now because we're not the best, and we know it as well. So, like, even though we didn't play that great today, I feel like just winning is feels good, at least for me.
I'm pretty confident going in CLG, but I feel like we can lose any game right now, so we'll try to prepare our best for it.
Yeah, I think winning for us on Sunday is really important. In my opinion, we will win, but we never know because right now we're not the best.
They're Kalista thrash bottom lane. It's going to be a massacre, Freak.
Now they're trying to scale, but it's going to be CLG dropping down the face of the mountain. They don't get anywhere out of base camp.
This game, I thought we played a pretty clean game, but it's also easy to play well when the enemy team doesn't really do anything.
And now it's time for Ruin to be attacked as well. The hook is going to land. He's going to be attacked. He cannot find the knockup. SyncID tries his hardest, but cannot quite do enough damage. It's 2 kills in for Cloud9. Make it a third.
Ruin
Six.
It is CLG, like Eric said, so it's not like it's a huge confidence boost, but I look forward to playoffs. I think losing games in regular season is not a big deal, and you know, looking at our regions, I'm sure no one counts out G2 from EU playoffs either, so I'm confident in playoffs, and I think that there are teams that look hot right now aren't even looking that hot, like Team Liquid, TSM, and Fly don't look like that insane either, so I'm sure that come playoffs, we'll be on top again.
When we started losing games, the players, they never stopped working hard. There was no motivational issues that we had to cover. They are all super motivated to figure out what was working on, and like they worked as a group just to figure out like how do we get better.
I don't think there was ever a point where people were like so frustrated or angry that we couldn't get better and we had like a really breaking point. We just tried to stay positive and get through this bad phase and figure out what's going wrong and where's the root of the problem, and I think we found the root and we fixed it.
So funny, like how they can't do anything.
They can't do something. I
don't know much about FlyQuest's strength right now, but I think we are 7-0 versus them in this year, so I feel very confident against them. I think we have their number and they have some sort of mental block versus us.
They're not an insane team, so we don't have to do anything like crazy to beat them. We're just trying to keep to our strengths and make sure we're the best in the best form possible going into the match.
It's really, really awesome that when this match will send us to Worlds. I haven't been to Worlds in 2 years now, and I really want to go back there and show people that I absolutely got it. So this means a lot to me to make the Worlds. It doesn't add pressure, it just makes it more fun, I guess. So I'm really excited for this match.
Well, I mean, playoffs are different. It's not best of one, you know? Best of five. We have five games, which is even you fucked up the draft, you can fix it immediately. Like, you know. Come on, guys. Like, I've been worried like fucking five years in a row. Like, how many best of five we've been, you know? Like, it's that easy.
We got it, guys. Don't worry.
Cloud9 in 2020 is 7-0 against FlyQuest. They're not exactly having a close record right about now, but champ select is complete and the players loading onto the Rift. It's time for game one of FlyQuest versus C9.
I think this year versus FlyQuest will be an easy 3-0, and I think the player we should look out for is Barber, because sometimes he'll end and we gotta look out for him.
We've got a Raptor battle here at level one. Blabber down to 200 HP using the smite. Now has to flash away. Blabber, what are we even fighting for those four mana? It's chickens.
Game one was just really hard from the get-go. Like Blabber died twice, first at Raptors and then at blue buff. So then like it's hard for anyone to play when the jungler's that far behind.
Santorin's not done. They are not stopping anytime soon. Santorin leading the charge. That's the second kill of the game here for FlyQuest. Two deaths now on to Blabber.
It was tough from the start, and then we ended up fumbling a fight at Rift Herald at like 8 minutes or something. And then after that, the game just like snowballed out of control, it felt like.
FlyQuest in 30 minutes will put all of that 7-0 this year talk to rest. They will win their first game of the year against Cloud9, and they will start this series off 1-0.
Yeah, I too much early.
I mean, it sucks to lose a game like that where you feel like it just like went out of control so fast, so early, but it's also like when you're discussing for game two, it's like, all right, well, let's not die twice in the first 2 minutes of the game, and then like we'll be able to play, and like we were pretty confident that we would still be able to win at that point.
Just reset and go next and change draft a little bit and try again. I mean, in game two, we didn't die level one. This is an improvement. And then Volibear killed himself in our tower, trying to gank us.
Ignar going for it. Flash into the play. Death sentence afterwards. Santorin, what are you doing, man?
Did he not see the cleanse?
For me, it's a game losing mistake. But then we had a bad fight in the Volibear. I think we were too greedy for the crab and we got punished for it, which was really bad. We ended up dying like four people for nothing. We just have left the area and it was just over.
Oh, Ignar. Oh, we are not done yet. It's time for a fight as Blabber goes for the kick flash and then tries to escape, but Turtle is after him. Looks for a little bit more damage here with the auto attack. He's going to be traded away one for one. Ignar looking to escape now as they're after him in full pursuit. It's Cloud9 going after the kills, but Niski is popped by Power of Evil. The bear is there. He may have made a mistake in the bottom lane, but he just don't care. Look at the plays coming out here from FlyQuest.
Everyone tries to fight all the time, even in comps where like we super outscale them and we get a lead early, and just like turns into really messy games that are just like bad.
Very low solo looking to find the kill onto Blabber. Yumi keeping him alive. Power of Evil still looking to get himself away as Turtle has to flash. Niski's going to be kited. Power of Evil coming back in looking for the damage, but now he may have put himself in the wrong spot. He did! Shut down for Sven, and Cloud9 take that fight. Seven.
You have a hell fight, you won the fight, and that was probably the game winning fight.
And Cloud9 turn this game around after FlyQuest take a Baron and tie this series up 1-1.
Felt messy, even though we were in a very free win position early in the game.
Okay, we got a minute.
I think we just need to have better control the area so that I can not be the only person, I think.
Yeah,
if I... Because I think if they shed, we should always talk about it.
We had another little one disaster this game.
Delayed invade here for FlyQuest. Going to put it to them very quickly.
We talked about it. We said we can fight, but in hindsight, we really can't fight at all. I get hooked, I flash it. Blabber takes a huge chunk, gets forced to flash out. And I should have just given up the blue buff and went around, but I took a short path for no reason, and I died, and it was really bad.
Because it means FlyQuest weren't able to just steal this buff away cleanly. Over the wall goes Ignar. Remember, Sven's got no flash, and that is a level one Ezreal. Click, click, boom, with the shotgun in the face. That is first blood for Santorin and FlyQuest.
I mean, the game went fine anyways. Like the game played out slowly, but it was fine for us. Nothing really happened for a while, and then...
Yeah, we were winning, we got Baron, and then we just started dying everywhere.
Power of Evil's about to take a nap. The QSS wakes him back up. Niski's not going to find the mark there with a paddle star, but he doesn't even need to do it. Power of Evil is down, so is Solo. This game is just completely out of FlyQuest's hands right now. Cloud9 are outplaying them.
The game's already in a position where we can't lose if we just play, like, slightly well. We don't have to play well at this point. But Niski dies, then Eric dies, then I die. I think Senna gets a kill on Eric, shut down. Yeah. And Nasir gets one on me, which is 1k gold to Nasir. And Nasir had a troll build, but he was playing QSS and stuff in this game. And he was like a bot. Like he had Nasir 2 QSS and a haunting guy or something like that. And I was 3.5 items. I would one shot everyone in this game and end the game. They can't win at a point. If we have like decent play, we can't lose. I think even a bad team can win that position. We just fucked up so hard and it was really embarrassing, almost, I would say.
Now, they might face check. If Solo's able to grab this taunt, that could be really huge. Here comes your Shurima shuffle. More CC coming through. Sven's gonna be killed. That is the start that FlyQuest was hoping and praying for. Vulcan wants to get away, but Turtle's got him in his sights. Cat versus gun. I'm taking the gun every time. Licorice dies now as well. And FlyQuest just found 3-0.
So, feels really bad to lose that situation. And then we had this whole
pause thing.
Be very careful about putting it in the very edge if you want full vision of the ramp. Blabber's going in. Power of Evil is the target here, but now Blabber's in some trouble. Ignar tanking on the front line, but Niski's able to grab the kill. It's a one-for-one trade. Jungler for support. Ignar's out of the picture, and so is Blabber, but FlyQuest will continue to push down the mid lane here. The Cloud9 Tier 1 turret in mid is still standing 35 minutes into this game. However, the Tier 3 turret in the bottom lane killed off by the minions.
All right, well, we get a little pause.
You don't see it in the VOD of the game, but we chase Senna. Senna dies, Asir dies, and only...
Graves was like in a position to die as well.
I'm playing midway. Exhausting him. Okay, look at Asir. Asir flashing.
Just kill Asir if you can.
Yeah. Nice, Asir's dead. I need a red.
I'm
good. I want Graves, I have also.
What?
What?
What the fuck, man?
We can't talk.
I'm finding out what's happened.
Okay. Can I use the bathroom, ref? Ref?
Sorry, what's the question?
Can I use the bathroom?
Let me ask. While they're discussing the problem, typically we don't allow you guys, but I'll ask McCain.
problem?
Mouse issues.
We are not allowed to talk during pauses, so we wait 2-3 minutes. We ask the ref what's going on. Tells us they're investigating a mouse issue on Graves, and we're like, okay.
Oh, like.
After half an hour of pause, and we're in the dark here, we don't get to know anything, the ref says they're going to chrono break the game.
So I'm pretty sure we're going to chrono break. We don't know exactly until when.
That's right.
I'll let you guys know.
What?
Why? That's so crazy, by the way.
Because his mouse was disconnecting and he wasn't controlling his character. We don't know till when. I'll let you guys know, though.
Okay.
Yeah, Senna's gonna be alive, Asuna's gonna be alive, because they're gonna go in and, yeah, it's fine.
So we're like, okay. Sucks for us, right? Because the game was won for us, right? And they decided to corner break it into the middle of the team fight, which, in my opinion, was way more favorable for FlyQuest than for us. Because this time, only Asir dies and I die, which is better for FlyQuest than before when Senna died, Asir died, and Graves was gonna die as well. So it just felt like so fucking unfair, I think. And we also weren't being told anything about the process. We're just being told, pause, mouse issue. Okay, corner break. This is the time. Let's go.
All right, guys, let's see.
If we get the shittiest position ever, I'm going to be so mad. Actually, I can't even see where I am, by the way. I'll be away.
Wait, my camera's on the fountain.
Oh, okay. We're here.
But okay. my camera's not even in the fight.
Here, you look at my monitor.
Or you power me.
Oh, look at Sven's.
So okay,
this is so I'm sorry, but like my host is gonna die and I can't see. So I can't do anything in this fight. Zen will die in 1 second and I can't see my camera. My camera's in fountain right now. Not over my camera.
Oh yeah, because you're me.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Sure is.
For some reason Phil Vulcan's mouse, his character's screen was in our base when the game unpaused, so he couldn't see anything what that was happening. And they can see all of us because their characters are different positions, so it's like, it felt so unfair that it chrono break to that point instead of like further back to before I chased the Senna. So it felt like super one-sided for them. And when he paused the game, even if Graves doesn't die there, we still killed Asir and Senna. And then we will get Elder most likely, and probably Baron afterwards. And then the game is completely different. So I felt like the corner break was super unfair to us.
Yeah, if we lose this game, then whatever.
Yeah, just focus on this play then.
Yeah.
Focus on the play. I think GPME can carry this. If I'm able to get on Eric, I think we can win.
Let's resume the thrilling conclusion of the team fight.
Back into the fight. Turtle's able to grab the kill. On to Sven. Going ham. Don't work. Power of Evil. Now the kill in retaliation. Cloud9, they lose their AD carry. They take out the enemy mid laner. Remember, the Elder Drake is alive, and C9 is heading towards him.
Oh my goodness. I actually just love it when it gets to this tense stage of the game. Elder Dragon on the board here for Cloud9. They do have Smite ready, but Santorin also has Smite, and he's got a spell shield and dash available to get over the wall. Pick onto Solo.
Oh, Solo is taking so much damage, but Turtle's able to show up and keep him alive here a little bit. Nice chain CC coming out. Santorin going in. Collateral damage.
Healing you, Eric? Or
run, run, run.
I need any help.
You want to
TP in 8 seconds.
Okay.
TP in 8 seconds. Just all time. I'll be there.
Okay. 50. Is your mid have TP? They might just force it.
I can't. It's not a thing. Go
okay.
Fight back. We need to get.
Okay, push away. Push away. We need to push away no matter what.
Push bots?
Yeah.
And get mid?
So stupid.
It's fine.
Game only.
Cloud9 is nowhere near the Elder Drake. FlyQuest grabbed themselves that huge buff.
Okay, try to fight them here.
Okay, slashed. Sending all for a better angle, so no.
FlyQuest with a pick onto the enemy jungler means now they're able to continue pushing, looking for even more. Sven gets himself away. Santorin's nearly going to be killed off, but the Stand United will make sure he doesn't lose that Guardian Angel.
Look at us here. Well,
just fight them if you can.
No, it's over.
Yeah, good job.
He even though I was triggered from this chrono break, that was obviously in their favor. I felt like we just won the game regardless, so it felt fucking disappointing. Yeah, felt like really like
everywhere
shitty.
Else, where I'm not, I feel like not do anything because let me point by one. Like yeah. When I said I'm mid, I'm winning. Eric dies, and that was bot. If he dies, and the one dragon is my fault, but we shouldn't be getting top trap before dragon. We had 10 million worse top trap. Just play where I am, I think, and trust me. We're playing too impatiently, I think. Yeah. The game was free, but even besides the front rate thing, we should have won the game, which never happened.
Yeah.
So I wanted to just, if we play better, we'll be fine. They're playing so bad, these guys. But, yeah. Just play slower. We're really fun.
Game 4 was tough. I don't know. I honestly don't remember that much of it. Like, we got a pretty big lead topside early just from ganking solo a lot because he was playing like too aggressively. And then the rest of the game was just like us trying to team fight and we just lost out every time.
Power of Evil with the ulti down onto the enemy jungler. You cannot outplay the point and click. Sven running away. He's gonna go over the wall probably, but Solo is right here waiting. Taunt over the wall looking for the kill. Sven is gone. Santorin's chasing down the cat. Power of Evil will fall to Licorice. Vulcan trying to stay alive. He's ulting all on his lonesome. That cat is on the run. He's homeward bound, but he's going down.
So I think once again, we were in a winning position in the game and we overreached a little bit. Trying to force something that we don't have to force. Just play slow, let GP carry, but we didn't do that.
FlyQuest are this close to qualifying for Worlds. Nexus turret number one is gone. Cloud9 must make their defense here.
It's over.
GG.
Man.
Just felt disappointed and slightly like, I don't know, frustrated, I guess. I had odd level play because I think everyone thought we would be so much better.
I mean, I thought we'd beat FlyQuest because last time we scrimmed them, I think was like 2 or 3 months ago, I think 2 months or something, and feel like we were always being good against them, everyone in our team, but then we arrived on stage and they were just really different, and we also played really poorly that day for some reason. I think we didn't expect them to be like this different, I guess, but yeah, I'm not sure what happened in the FlyQuest series. I think we just played really bad as a team.
Yeah, I think we'll be fine. Just need to regroup and talk about the games, and I'm sure we can beat EG. They are not that good either, so should be fine.
Well, we're getting ready for a matchup that many people did not expect to see today. Cloud9 in the lower bracket facing off against Evil Geniuses.
I don't think EG is much of a special team. They're very simple for the most part, and I don't think they're very good either.
And that is EG taking advantage of the mid laner being away. Zazel picks up another kill at 3-0-2, and Evil Geniuses makes a quick snap judgment. Shockwave coming down as well, and they're fighting under the turrets of Cloud9 now.
They will be able to force on this Baron.
We were losing. I think early game was really rough. I think we were down a bit, but I think when we started forcing late game, Eric was able to get good flanks, and Nissi was able to get good flanks.
Now getting pushed back here by Blabber versus 2, and no, Cloud9 is able to rain on EG's parade. More kills coming through as we're going to see that as Bang coming back up, and Bang going back down.
This should be C9 inside the base rift. Sven, he turns ghost, he doesn't have the damage.
But
one more, Blabber hits
it! Oh, gets it, Blabber!
I mean, game 2, they picked Cassio into TF,
And from that point, I knew that nothing happened till 6, we'd win, because then we can make any place, anywhere. And that's kind of what happened as well, where we won early skirmishes, because we're also stronger.
Spend the extra gold. Golden glue! Ooh, nice turn.
Almost. A little bit of damage. It's inevitable, but he's trying to do what he can before he goes down. Another one onto the glue in the mid lane. Get that same result. The inhibitor's going to be going down. There's another hook. Oh!
Not too good.
And now they're going to be taking down EG in their own base. 30 minutes on this one. A little bit faster, Kobe, as they found the way this composition was working from the get-go. Cloud9 takes game two quite swift.
We made two or three mistakes, which let them get like two or three dragons, I think. Which kind of sucked, but I think that game was still decent, so, yeah.
I was running it down for the first 15 minutes of the game.
And now it's Flabber in the alcove. Can he make it? Nope, he cannot.
But I think once we were able to teamfight and regroup, oh, also Huni was like just chain feeding. It's crazy.
Every time I had ult, I had a target to kill, so it was pretty easy for me. And I felt like Huni was just literally just running it just to give me kills.
You get it.
All right, Cloud9.
Huni, gonna pull down that equalizer and rinse and repeat on Huni. That seems to be the name of the game right now for Cloud9. They're gonna have to chase him real far into the turret. The flash forward and almost. EG with a 2k gold lead here, feeling like they can roll him through the jungle alone, and that's not the case. Cloud9 pick up another kill onto Huni.
I don't know. I think they kind of give us the win. We're just dying permanently whenever I have ult up there.
They need. Now Zazel drops Ben, so the marksman is down on both sides. Zazel and Golden Glue, however, just getting pushed out of the fights with slivers of health. Huni and Sven on the back line. Can they do enough damage or just be a distraction? Neither is enough, and Cloud9 is able to whittle away for the Bud Light Ace against Evil Geniuses.
Good job, boys.
You play
live
play.
Another day.
Love
it. Man, I
not you, me.
Big damage. Big damage.
Actually, look at that. Yeah, we watched the TSM GG games because they're on. Just because like whoever won was gonna be our opponent. So obviously we're trying to see like how the teams are playing, what they're drafting, and stuff like that.
Oh my God!
Oh, BDD!
Oh,
BDD!
Ah, Bjergsen,
Bjergsen.
Ash versus Mordekaiser. Bam, 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 bam.
They found a way.
They found a way.
Bjergsen. Sure. That's yeah, like spanning the cringe for him.
It's paradigm. It's Bjergsen.
Ult. Please ult. Why does that ult?
Arrow. Oh! The arrow. Look at the arrow.
Double lift. It's Bray. Oh,
double lift. It's Bray. It's actually Bray.
Double
Bray.
Wait, they actually just entered to get Broken Blade all this gold.
Oh my God.
Oh my, I've actually killed him.
Dog almost joined.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Jax has TP.
Who thinks he's useful?
We all wanted GG to win, I'm pretty sure. But none of us actually knew who would win because we think GG is an easier opponent for us, but we didn't necessarily think that GG was worse than TSM.
Biofrost is just trolling his team at this point. Like, this guy is creeping.
Callie just saw the video.
We are all fans of TSM.
Oh,
man,
that blows.
They did not win, obviously. So, I mean, obviously we're playing TSM, right? But I don't think we really care that much about who our opponents were going to be.
TSM and Cloud9. These two historic organizations have battled endlessly at the top of the LCS. Cloud9 are trying to keep their unbroken streak since entering the LCS, 7 straight Worlds appearances. TSM as an organization also have 7, but there's only one spot left, Clayton. It's going to be epic.
I mean, it's just hard because I think that like coming from Spring Split where we were as dominant as we were, we like everyone expected us to just like win summer again and like smash everybody again. So it would feel really, really bad to not even make it to Worlds. Like we already didn't go to MSI because of COVID. So missing out on Worlds would really suck because I want a chance to play internationally with my team.
for me personally, I'm not really thinking about, oh, this is like our last chance to Worlds. I'm really just thinking like, I really want to win. I don't want to lose again. It's honestly just really depressing if, let's say next week is the end of our season. Like, I mean, it's August and we don't play again until like February. But just imagine not going to Worlds. Like, you're a pro player and you don't get to go to the most prestigious event of the entire year. Like, it's honestly just a disappointment. We all want to be the best. We all know we can be the best. And I mean, you got to go to Worlds to prove that, right? So I don't want to miss Worlds.
How do I feel worse? I don't know. It's gonna be exciting, but you never know before we get to China, you know? So you can ask us again when we get to China.
I went to Worlds first 3 years of my career and then 2 years without it, and I really hate it sitting at home watching Worlds and watching other people play, and I'm just happy that I have a good chance now of making the Worlds, and I don't really care if it's online or not. I don't think it's that big of a difference for the most part, but yeah, like I said, we take those.
And Eric Hot, some troubles.
It's fine.
You have to peel the bananas out.
We were stopping everyone. We were winning a lot of scrims. We scrimmed to you like 4 times that week, and it went well every single time. So I was like, okay, we're still good. We had a bad day against FlyQuest. Whatever, happens, right? So I thought, coming to the match against TSM, that our scrims were going pretty well, honestly.
The teams that we played versus were not really trying scrims. I think they were like kind of inting a little bit. So it was hard to kind of judge our level or get a lot from those games. Even though we had like a really high win rate in that week, it wasn't very productive.
I mean, the practice leading to TSM was really terrible in my experience, because the quality of our scrims was just really bad. I wasn't sure if we were actually good or if the enemies were just bad in our scrims, so it was kind of hard to know.
I feel like it's like a feeling when you go into a series versus TSM, and it just feels like you're already playing from your back foot before game one. And it's just because of like practice and like the way we approached the direction that we wanted to take leading up to Fly and then eventually TSM. It just felt like we were automatically on our back foot. In the back of my mind, going to TSM, it's just like, I hope we make some damn good plays today. And I hope we can pull off a miracle. And it's a really shitty feeling thinking like that. And like, I really kept it to myself, but it's just a pretty shitty feeling.
For a play perspective, then don't rush to hit objective. That's one of the bad habits. And then don't hesitate to say things to your teammates to be careful kind of things, because most of times, when we are losing, and when we are losing stuff, is when solos move, our mid, battle, and jungler die. Or when no one's are catching the mid wave, our side laners are dying, right? So don't think your teammates are same page as you. Just say things and make it work, right? And then part of that, most of the times, when we are talking about only our play, not talking about what they can do, we are usually like, oh shit, like, they're here, something like that. So why are you guys are talking things you guys are playing? Just say one or two things what they can do. They can trap, they are not on the map yet, something like that. They're wasting tempo so much, so we can do this, something like that, right? That's always good. Then yeah, that's about it. Let's play our best lever. We just maybe follow, right?
Yep. Also, just don't play yourself trying to flex too hard. Just do what you can and we'll win the game that way.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't need to go out of your way to help anybody. Yeah. But if you see the angle, go for it.
Alright, let's win today.
1, 2, 3! Yeah!
I mean, going against TSM, at least for me, I thought we could beat them, because I just thought that if you just play our game, it should work.
I was pretty confident. But I wasn't 100% sure that we were going to win, you know? I was very confident that we could win because we were having really good scrim results.
I mean, I felt a bit nervous going into the TSM games, but I was pretty confident that we were a strong team and that we figured out how we wanted to draft. We had like a good series against EG, and I was like, I don't know, I thought we had a good chance in the games.
Well, with champion select complete, let's waste no more time and send things over to Summoner's Rift for game one of this playoff match.
The game went pretty badly. Level one, I think this he flashed in too far, ended up dying.
I don't know how that's gonna work out too well here. Spica is gonna be kept alive, and now Niski's having to run away. This is turning into a bloodbath here at level one. First blood over to Broken Blade. Well, the guns have already been fired off in the top lane, and now TSM is striking back. Labber is already out of this fight, and Spica is leading the charge into the remaining Cloud9 lines, but Liquor is packed to wallop. Send Spica right back to the spawn platform. Niski gonna be taken down there by Broken Blade.
Yeah, I think we lost again because we didn't play our comp well enough.
Got the kill, and Licorice, try as he might, will not do a thing. Biofrost goes into the stasis at the last minute, and TSM comes out swinging and takes game one.
Just either play slower early game and then play it through neutrals only, or kill by strong. Use it right now. No demographic, be far and free.
Game two, we had a different draft. We were in our comfort zone now in this draft. I thought it was just a free win.
I think game two, our draft plan was a lot smoother because we got Senatom, I think.
Our comp was just way better than theirs.
With the save, getting Sven away. Bjergsen and Niski into a 1v1 off the side of the fight, but it's already going to turn into an absolute mess. Niski grabbing the kill on to double it, Biofrost. Now going to be in some trouble. Niski's making it a double.
Once you get ahead, these kind of comps, the game is just over.
Spica's dead first here in the fight. Niski coming in on the side. Labber is dominating. TSM evaporating.
Oh my.
And Cloud9 will slaughter their entire roster. Cloud9 is not messing around. They are not padding stats, but they are grabbing their first win here in this series, tying us up 1-1.
So we ended up picking the set again. I was playing against Lucian, and then they had TF and Evelynn this time.
That does mean TSM with a move timer, though, because Bjergsen could shove in the wave. Evelynn's so good at diving. Here we go. The charm ready to go. Chain CC it together with the gold card, and Spica cashes in.
I was like hugging my tier 3 tower, and they're like killing me with like Senna ult and Evelynn and like Lucian under my tower. So I just, that game just like felt really, really hard. We ended up getting like one good team fight.
Evelynn's dead.
Evelynn's dead.
She's dead.
Yeah.
And then we had like one bad team fight, and we ended up losing that one.
Wait.
I thought we did okay, given the draft that we had never played before, or played against before, so it was okay, I guess. I thought that the game was winnable. It was like very close, and some fights, that game could have been won very easily, like by a small difference in from some fights, right? So felt sad.
That's the like one game where it was actually winnable, and we messed up, and it should have been a closer series. And yeah, I think we should have won game 3.
When we're down, it really sucks because you're like, oh, this could be the last game. We're actually going to miss Worlds if we lose this game.
I mean, I just want to play Lucian Evelynn. I've been playing it all week.
Yeah,
and every
they,
single
they
game.
They had first pick the chance, but
yeah, but if they don't.
Okay, they don't pick it.
Yeah,
you're fine. But then play it to Nilly, is that fine?
Yeah, it's fine. Whatever.
Okay, then that's fine.
The last game was very, it showed so much evidence that we have not been practicing very well.
I was fairly nervous, but also at the same time, like RedSide was just winning every game, so I wasn't too worried about it, because we had side selection since we lost. So we chose to go back to RedSide. We decided we were gonna do a pretty similar draft to what we did last time, but they ended up changing their first pick. So then the draft went a different way. They picked Jace Blind, and I countered with Wukong.
I picked Jace.
Jace into
it might be mid.
Oh, that's possible. Sure. I don't think so though, but
I think Wukong is really OP here. Yeah.
They blind pick Jace, And then our last pick was going to Eric. And then we're just like, oh shit. When was the last time we played against the Jace? And then when was the last time we played Wukong, which is the champion we picked into Jace top? We're like, huh. No one said anything, but everyone was just like, okay. Let's hope for the best. Oh man. This is like a shitty feeling thinking about that.
We're gonna help Ligurish out here a little bit. Does walk up towards Broken Blade. He's got the charm ready to go. Wants to get in range for the whiplash, but he can't do it. Tries to fire off the hate spike, but Broken Blade with his own flash away.
We ganked him, got his flash, but then I ended up making a mistake and dying afterwards because he like guessed that I was in the bush and got a big chunk on me and then ended up killing me. So that was really bad.
Ligurish is about to die to Broken Blade. Two more auto attacks. One'll do it. First blood for Broken Blade. Chunk.
And that's the early pressure that you want to try and play off of. I expect him to go with the Blade of the Ruin King early game build. Here's a repeat game.
All right, Speaker up top side. Looking for the kill on the Ligurish here yet again. It is trouble in top lane for Cloud9.
And then from that point on, I was like, anytime I tried to ward, there was like a Skarner in the bush just killing me. So the early game was like really, really hard.
Yeah, we were all playing champs that are good in lane, but didn't win lane, so.
Niski's going hard on Bjergs.
Look at the calling, all of it being eaten by Bjergsen here, but Niski wisely stopping the aggro. Bjergsen goes into the stopwatch. He baits Niski in for Biofrost to show up and finish him off.
I mean, at some point, I just knew the game was lost. Like, after we came out of laning phase, if I was like, yeah, the game's probably lost. Like,
I was just thinking of, like, how good we were and, like, why the fuck did it go so wrong and what we could have done to do better, I guess, but I felt like I was most disappointed in us because we were just so good as a team and then we didn't figure out on how to snowball on our success, I guess. And we were just in that slump that we never got off.
In him, it's two in hits down and TSM with Baron pushing towards Nexus turrets. Cloud9, 5v5. They must find some sort of a way to defend this. Ligurish is trying to teleport behind TSM, trying to find some sort of a flank, but Finn is already gone. Ligurish has made his way into the back line, but it does not even matter. Vulcan's going to be killed away. Broken Blade finally going to be shut down there by Niski. Now Niski down to 200 HP. Double is looking for the last little bit of damage here as Ligurish also tries to retreat.
I'm
dead.
I was kind of shocked, I guess, that we didn't make worlds because we kind of had like a very easy path to do it in our minds. We only had to win one best of five against FlyQuest, which is a team we beat the whole year. We never had any problems versus them. After that, we only had to win like two series versus EG and TSM. And yeah, we didn't do it, so. I was kind of shocked and obviously sad.
For me, missing Worlds is really sad because I feel like every time, or like last year when I got to Worlds, then I became so much better after it, and not having the experience would suck for me, for sure, so, yeah.
I wasn't really thinking much after we lost. I generally know that's when I'm feeling the worst, when I have nothing to really think about at all. Like, I'm not thinking about the game, I'm not thinking about why we lost or like what happened. There's nothing much for me to think about besides the fact that, I mean, my season's just over. So it was just really sad, but there's really not much I was thinking.
We didn't go to Worlds, right? Like that's kind of the big thing, right? Like we were this super, super strong team in Spring Split. We were like ahead of everybody. MSI ended up getting canceled, so we didn't get to like test ourselves internationally. And we all thought that like we would be able to do it at Worlds, and then we just ended up fumbling and we didn't make it. So that just really, really sucks.
In the end, it's not really the player's fault. Like I never want anyone to blame the players. It's like if you're blaming Eric for dying this many times on Wukong versus Jace, then you guys are nuts. Like, it's not any of our players' faults. It's just the way, I guess the direction that we wanted to take practice is definitely on the coaches and it's not about the players. So don't ever blame the players for anything. You know, they tried their best. Like, these are like five players that work really hard and it's just they were limited that day, so yeah.
This time, I guess I've learned to handle the disappointment. I guess it was weird to me that we started Spring Split, like, what was it, 27-2, and then we went 9-0 in Summer Split. We went from being like 35-2 or whatever, I can't remember what the record we had, to being like 5 losses in the second half, losing to like TL, Wild Thieves, TSM, EG. I was like, whoa, lost to these fucking guys, that's embarrassing, right? And I thought, okay, it's a slump, we had a bad slump. We tried Sun Wukong, tried Lux Sona, it happens. So now back to playoff mode, right? But then it all came crashing down in Flypo series, I think, versus Fly, that series. I still think we should have won that series. We played really poorly in game 1, 2, and 3. And the corner break was kind of unfortunate, but it's not really an excuse. It's more of a cherry on top, I suppose. That series was more disappointing to me than anything. But I guess just over the years, I've learned to deal better with losses. I'm still mad I didn't go to Worlds this year because I want to compete with the best. You know, I want to show everyone that I still got it at a world-class level. So I'm disappointed as always, but there is much to do about it. You can cry about it or whatever for a day or two, and then you gotta regroup yourself and think ahead, you know, how can I come back stronger for next year and then try to be the best person and player I can be in Spring 2019.